Hello friends, welcome to MySQL video tutorials series. In this video tutorial, I would like to discuss how to select a specific column or columns from a table. To select a specific column or columns from a table and retrieve the data within them, we take help of select command and list of column names separated by comma. Basic syntax for selecting a specific column or columns from a table is select, we write list of column names separated by comma, from, we write table name, semicolon. For example, select ID, comma name from TBL underscore faculty semicolon. It selects ID and name columns from TBL underscore faculty table and returns the data within them, guys. Let's go to MySQL console and understand how do we select a specific column or columns from a table and retrieve the data within them. Here I say show databases semicolon. We know that show databases command displays list of databases currently available inside MySQL server. I hit enter. You can see that it has displayed list of databases currently available inside MySQL server. Now I want to create a database for City College. How do we create a database, guys? We say create database, then we write the database name. I say here db underscore city underscore college semicolon. I hit enter. You can see that query is executed successfully. Let's check out whether db underscore city underscore college database is created or not. I say here show databases semicolon. I hit enter. You can see that db underscore city underscore college database is created inside MySQL server. I want to create some tables inside db underscore city underscore college database. To do that, first I should select the database. How do we select a database, guys? We say use, then we write the database name which we want to select. I say here db underscore city underscore college semicolon. I hit enter. You can see that database changed is displayed. That means currently selected database is db underscore city underscore college, guys. I say here show tables semicolon. We know that show tables command displays list of tables available in the currently selected database. I hit enter. It is telling empty set. That means there are no tables available inside db underscore city underscore college database, guys. Let's create a TBL underscore faculty table. How do we create a table? We say create table, then we write the table name. I say here TBL underscore faculty, opening bracket, hit enter. Then we write list of column definitions. Faculties are going to have ID. I say here ID. Data type I set int. Size I say 11. Int of 11 indicates ID column can store whole numbers containing up to 11 digits. I say comma, hit enter. Faculties are going to have name. I say here name. Data type I say varchar of 25. Varchar of 25 indicates name column can store strings containing up to 25 characters. Comma, hit enter. Faculties are going to have salary. I say here salary. Data type I say int of 11. Hit enter, bracket close, semicolon, hit enter. Query is executed successfully. Let's check out whether TBL underscore faculty table is created or not. I say here show tables semicolon, hit enter. You can see that TBL underscore faculty table is created inside DB underscore city underscore college database, guys. I want to insert some records inside a TBL underscore faculty table. How do we insert records in a table, guys? We take help of insert into command. I say here insert into. Then we write the table name TBL underscore faculty. In between pair of parentheses, we write list of column names separated by comma. TBL underscore faculty table has three columns, ID, name, and salary. Then we say space values. In between pair of parentheses, we write list of values to be inserted. I say here 1 comma Ramesh comma 1000. First faculty ID will be 1, name will be Ramesh, salary will be 1000. I say here semicolon, hit enter. Query is executed successfully. That means one record is inserted inside TBL underscore faculty table, guys. I want to insert one more record. Faculty ID I say 2, faculty name I say Rajesh, faculty salary I say 2000. I hit enter. One more record is inserted. I want to insert one more record. I say here faculty ID 3, faculty name Rupesh, faculty salary 3000. I hit enter. One more record is inserted inside TBL underscore faculty. I want to insert one more record. I say here faculty ID 4, faculty name Suresh, faculty salary 4000. Hit enter. One more record is inserted. Now I want to select all columns from TBL underscore faculty table and retrieve the data within them. How do we select all columns from a table, guys? We say select star from, then we write the table name. I say TBL underscore faculty semicolon. Star indicates all columns. Select all columns from TBL underscore faculty. I hit enter. You can see that it has displayed all columns from TBL underscore faculty and data within them. If you want to select all columns from a table and retrieve the data within them, you can write list of column names also, guys. For example, I say here select, then I write list of column names separated by comma. I say here ID, comma name, comma salary. Then I say from TBL underscore faculty semicolon. Instead of writing star, I'm writing list of all column names separated by comma. I hit enter. We get the same result, you can see that, right? In this video tutorial, we are trying to understand how do we select a specific column or columns from a table and retrieve the data within them. This time, I want to select only ID column from TBL underscore faculty and retrieve the data within it. How do we do that? We say select, then we write ID, then we say from, then we say TBL underscore faculty semicolon. What we are saying? We are telling select ID column from TBL underscore faculty and return the data within it. I hit enter. You can see that only ID column is displayed, right? Now I want to select ID column as well as name column. I say here select ID comma name from TBL underscore faculty semicolon. I hit enter. You can see that this time it has displayed ID column and name column. That is how you select specific column or columns from a table and retrieve the data within them, guys. Understanding? If I want to display name and salary columns, what I have to do? Select name comma salary from TBL underscore faculty semicolon. I hit enter. You can see that this time it has displayed name column and salary column, guys. So that is how you select specific columns from a table and retrieve the data within them, guys. Now I want to delete DB underscore city underscore college database because I don't want the database in my computer system. To delete the database, we say drop database. Then we write the database name. I say here DB underscore city underscore college semicolon. I hit enter. Query is executed. Let's check out whether DB underscore city underscore college database is deleted or not. I say here show databases semicolon. I hit enter. You can see that there is no DB underscore city underscore college database available inside the server. Now I want to exit from MySQL console. I say here exit semicolon. Hit enter. You can see that MySQL console is closed. That's it, guys, for this video tutorial. I hope you guys have clearly understood how to select a specific column or columns from a table and retrieve the data within them. I suggest you people to watch this video again and again, understand everything clearly. Try to remember all the commands that I teach in this video tutorial series. practice them as much as possible. If you like this video, hit the like button and share with your friends so that everyone will get benefited. For more benefits and be up to date, do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Keep learning, keep coding, keep sharing. Thank you guys, thank you very much. See you in the next tutorial. Thank you.